properly. I don't drive very well. I have a master driver also. So your question is, mukti is beyond going beyond jnana and adnana. That's perfectly all right. Okay? Knowledge and ignorance belong to the domain of a relativity. Okay? Atmadnana is beyond relativity. That means to realize I am the Atma. Now this vehicle is there called body mind, which is a vehicle. Okay, I can be a top class driver, but vehicle is faulty, the operation is not easy. So now the vehicle called body mind intellect has some vasanas. So the Atma has realized that I am the self. Now the body mind intellect vehicle has to be operating in the world. Some vasanas are coming and again saying, I am the body. So that has to be clear for effective usage of this vehicle. So then you can say, no, I don't need to use the vehicle effectively. I am okay, whatever vehicle is there. Okay, I don't want to drive. I want to relax at home. Relax. Right? This vehicle called body, mind, intellect, even after Atmadnana, requires food, requires breath, okay, requires a maintenance, cleanup. So nididhyasa, manana nididhyasa is a part of the cleanup of the system, so that it's very efficiently becomes a vehicle for service. Normally Atmadhana is given only to the people who have a very clean vehicle. That's why they have called what you call shama, dama, titiksha, upardi, shraddha, samadhana, mumukshatva. Only such a ripe sadhaka, guru will tell you are the Atma. Okay. Now, if we have to wait for that, for him, no manana nididhyasa is required because already he has cleaned up the vasanas. Right? Such a sadhaka is called the pure vehicle. For him, no practice is required. Shravana matra and more. He has come for Atmadhana, he has done everything practice possible before he is able to listen to the truth. Ripe sadhaka. But what about our case? We heard Atmadhana after a lot of trouble in life. Vasanas are pending. Okay? So now these vasanas have to be cleaned up with nididhyasa. Jnana gives liberation. Actually, the moment you get you are the Atma, you are liberated. In the sense, the clarity has set in. But your vehicle will not cooperate because of vasanas are pending. Okay? So the question will come. Yeah, I understood this, sir. But when I am practicing, facing my wife, somewhere I get angry. What to do? Because your vasana that she is a wife, she is a body. I am a husband because I am a body. That vasana is coming. Then after some time, wife looks at you again like this. Then again you come back. I am the Atma. You are wife. So jnana will shoot up. Jnana will come and go. Okay. Whereas jnana has to stabilize in the day-to-day operation. Some vasana.
Clean up.
Sustain itself. But for you, mukti, nothing else is required. Mukti is Atmadhana. But then vehicle, operation in the world,
still required.
Vasanas are have to be clear. Is this clear? The mukti is through Atmadhana, Shravana Matrena. Actually, for that, you are already qualified and you already understood what I have said. Okay? That is mukti. But the vehicle which is already has some fuel in this, prana in this, has to operate for next couple of years, being useful service to the world and your household, right? So that vehicle has to be maintained during with regular cleanup of samadhi practice.
Preventive maintenance.
Is this clear? Yes or no? Alright? So typically, please understand, whatever I have taught you Atmadhana will not be taught to a monk also. A monk also will be taught this after 20, 30 years of service, doing service. The service is given, karma yoga is given for him to vasanas. Now if I speak such a long times, even if I speak 1 month, what will happen? People will not come to the, you will not get it. So that's why for me, for I am giving Atmadhana first, then vasana clearance and service next. Whereas the prerequisite for Atmadhana is service and vasana clearance. What is it? Is it clear? What I told? Any questions? Okay. Next question. Yeah, go ahead.